Hi, I'm Thomas Udar of Elements. The main purpose of our link calculator is to give you an estimate of how a link should perform, and this is a tutorial on how to use it. On the map, you see the AP and the CPE pins, which can be dragged and dropped to wherever you want. The location is by default chosen based on your current geographical area. The AP location can be entered via address. Typing the address in, the AP position will be changed according to what you enter. Another option is to use GPS coordinates if you want. Same thing here. Entering the coordinates, the AP location changes. To fine-tune the location, it's good to switch to the satellite view, where you can see all the roofs and you can place the pin quite accurately where you need to. If you prefer miles over meters, you can switch to the imperial system by clicking the button below the map. Let's look at the AP settings. You can choose any of our antennas from the drop-down menu. Another drop-down menu lets you choose the channel width you want to use. Doing that, you might notice that for some of the widths, you will get a warning sign in the CPE settings and no results. This is because that particular CPE does not support the channel width you've chosen. So when choosing a channel width, you must know which ones your CPE supports. The gain of the antenna is shown next to the channel width and is set automatically depending on which antenna you select. You can set the transmitter output power and see the EIRP, which is the sum of the gain and the output power, so it's easy to ensure you meet the local EIRP limit. The down tilt of the AP can be adjusted by using the slider that goes up to 25 degrees of down tilt our antenna support. The height says how high above the ground level the AP is. If you're located on a roof of a building, enter the sum of the height of the building and the tower. In the advanced settings, you can change the frequency at which the link works. Despite the radiation patterns of our antennas are very stable over the whole band, it is good to change the frequency to the one you actually use for more accurate results. The parameters of the receiver can be changed in the CPE and results part. The drop-down menu lets you choose from the most popular CPEs of major manufacturers. If you didn't find the CPE you were looking for in the list, you can either select the generic 802.11ac or 802.11n radio, or leave us feedback about the CPE you want to have added. Gain of the CPE with an integrated antenna is fixed, so you naturally cannot edit it. But if the CPE does not have an integrated antenna, such as this one, you can set the gain according to what antenna you use. You can set the noise floor according to your knowledge, or just leave the default value if it's a completely new site. The height is similar to the AP settings. You should enter the height of the tower and the building combined if the CPE is on a roof. The results are highlighted by the colored rectangles and they tell you what is the received power the CPE should see and the SES rate you can expect. The graph below shows you the terrain profile of the path between the access point on the left side and the CPE on the right side. The received power graph shows what power you can expect at what distance. The vertical blue line indicates the location of the CPE. The colors on the graph indicate what MCS rate you can expect at what distance. For example, here you can see that the maximum range at MCS 9 is around 6.4 kilometers. This is also shown in the link details. If the recommended down tilt is non-zero, like in this case, the CPE antenna should have 2 degrees up tilt, so the antenna bore sites are aligned. Switching to the multi-CPE calculator, by clicking on the button in the left upper corner, you can predict the performance for more CPEs at the same time. All the settings are identical to the single CPE version, so we will highlight only the additional features of the multi-CPE version. The main difference is that you can see the coverage zones on the map, which makes the planning a lot easier because you immediately see what MCS rates you have in which area. While the highest MCS rates are usually the most desired ones, by clicking on the numbers on the MCS scale, you can turn on the lower MCS zones if you want to, and vice versa. You can turn off any MCS zone depending on what you're interested in. When you change any parameter in the settings or the heading of the AP antenna, the coverage will be recalculated, which takes a few seconds and it is indicated by the pulsating blue area corresponding to the antenna beamwidth at minus 6 decibels. You can add more CPEs through the button under the CPE settings or the one directly in the map. When working with more CPEs, it is important to be aware that the displayed coverage is always specific to the selected CPE. It says at the bottom of the map for which CPE is the coverage valid. You will recognize the CPE by inverted colors compared to the rest of them. In this example, the CPE 2, 3, and 4 are of the same type and settings. This is why there is no difference between the expected coverages as I'm switching between them. Based on this coverage, CPE 1 should also have MCS 9, but the results table says it works at MCS 7. This is because CPE 1 is a different device, so by selecting it, the coverage has to be recalculated and in the end looks differently compared to the rest of the CPEs. When this is done, the MCS number in the table for CPE 1 now matches the displayed coverage. By clicking on the icon in the right upper corner of the map, you can switch to the full screen mode for better user experience. The whole control and result panels are included there, so you can edit everything in the full screen mode as well as see the results. Sometimes you may notice that the coverage plot can have quite low resolution, like in this case. This is because the number of the data points in the plot is always the same, and the resolution of the plot is determined by the radius of the area you are looking at. You can adjust the radius by moving the red circle. If you want to improve the sharpness of the plot you're interested in, decrease the radius of the plot as much as possible. Doing that, after the calculation finishes, you see that the coverage plot is a lot sharper than before. When you're done with the calculator and want to save the results, you can download them into a PDF, so you have it ready when you're installing the link so you can check what performance you can approximately expect. This is just about everything you need to know about our link calculator. If you have any feedback, for example about a missing CPE in the list, feel free to let us know by clicking on the red feedback button at the bottom of the page. Thank you for your attention and have a nice day.